There are many people, let's face it, in an informal economy, when you calculate their profit, and sometimes we charge them withholding tax, you end up giving them a refund at the end of the year, because the tax is on profit. Having said that, there are those who are doing big business and are in the informal economy.
Yes.
It requires more than just the tax administration. For example, I'm for tax compliance as a tax administrator, and the last thing I would do is to do anything that would undermine, you know, compliance. But it is beyond the GRE to take on the mantle of a mass registration, you know, agency. That's not the work of GRE. It's the work of National Identification Authority. GRE would just be, you know, wasting resources, you know, attempting to give, you know, TIN to everybody who should rather have a national identification number. Of course, in many countries, once you have a national identification number, in some countries, it becomes your TIN. And in countries where they don't even have national identification number, like the US, where some states have a number, some don't, you know, have, you know, numbers, the social security number, which is everybody, subject to everybody who is doing, you know, even if you are not an employee, they can issue you a social security number, becomes. The point I'm making is that the national identification number can be a substitute for TIN, and GRA can adopt it, you know, for TIN purposes, but not the other way around. Because let me give an example. Most of the, and this is not to encourage non-compliance, let me be clear, but most of the people in the rural areas who are farmers, peasant farmers, who are taking their kids to school, and it's been withdrawn, that directive has been withdrawn anyway. What's their main source of income? It's peasant farming, and what they take to the local market. But our law exempts farming income from taxes. So what business do we have, you know, if predominantly their preoccupation is farming, from asking them? GRA would rather use those resources, you know, to be in the cities and Oyibi and the rest where people are doing brisk business, you know, like Makola and the rest, right? So I think that if we can make the national identification number simpler, then GRA can even adopt that, right? So you don't have to do even a separate registration, you know, for TIN. It can be the other way around, because the mandate of GRA does not cover, you know, every person in the economy, whether you are paying taxes or not paying taxes.